appearing before Parliament on Thursday this week, State Minister for Health Dr. Christopher Yomonsi told Parliament that Aga Khan Hospital in Nairobi had offered to treat 400 cancer patients who are receiving radiotherapy. This came bare after public uproar after the only machine at the Cancer Institute broke down.
We have got an offer from Aga Khan Hospital in Nairobi. They have offered to treat up 400 patients.
NTV has seen a letter signed by Aga Khan Hospital Nairobi Chief Executive Officer Sean Borouki confirming the offer. It reads in parts, "We would like to offer 400 free radiation therapy treatment to the most needy of the patients affected by the breakdown. We would also like to offer reduced prices to other patients that might need treatment." But a cancer expert at Mulago Hospital says it's only a handful of patients who are receiving radiotherapy treatment and whose selection will depend on the scientific results.
What does that leave us with this offer of 400 slots for treatment? I tell you, that is a lot of treatment. And if we are to select only the patients who, after surgery, they need radiotherapy, they are going to be very few. And that means that offer, we should use it, but we should use it in a way which is also reasonable.
However, he is grateful for the good gesture from Aga Khan Hospital.
Bet we might not even get to who qualify if we are to use strict criteria.
I see.
Yes. So we are not going to send everybody who is diagnosed with cancer when we actually have the means for treating them.
Dr. Yemu explains that 80% of the cancer patients ranging between 200,000 and 300,000 people in Uganda are receiving the advanced chemotherapy treatment.
The treatment for that type of the disease is also what we call systemic treatment. And the best systemic treatment we have is chemotherapy. So, the role of radiotherapy ideally is for what we call local disease. Now, local disease means you have a cancer in one spot of the body. So you kind of target your treatment at that one spot of the body with the aim of eliminating entirely the cancer.
He also revealed that the survival rate in Uganda is only 20% because many patients diagnose the disease in its late stages.
Most of our patients are coming with what we call advanced stage disease. And actually, in technical language, we say they come with systemic disease. Now, systemic disease, that means the disease has gone throughout the whole body.
Explaining why the cancer scourge poses a grave threat, Orem said for every 10,000 Ugandans, there are at least 300 cancer patients. Dr. Orem also revealed that Mulago has an alternative machine that can improvise for the one that has broken down.
We have a very brand new radiotherapy machine, which is called high-dose brachytherapy equipment, which has been installed. We got it just in February. And that is the machine you use for treating cervical cancer. And the majority, over 40% of our patients actually have that. And that means for our patients now who have cervical cancer, there should not be a problem because we have the means of treating them. It is like a socket. If you put another applicator, you can use it for treating other cancers. For instance, you can use it for treating cancer of the anus. You can use it for treating cancer of the esophagus. You can even use it for treating cancer of the prostate, so long as you have the applicator for those diseases. And those applicators we can buy. Actually, we should put our resources in making sure we get those applicators in the meantime so that we can increase the range of the disease which that machine can treat.
Jingo Francis, NTV Weekend Edition.